Hugely disappointing. We knew we had a young side, an inexperienced side, but we thought we had quite an exciting side. But the fact is that we just haven't performed almost in any game, and clearly that's really disappointing. It's desperately hard, you know. I too have followed England cricket abroad, and you feel hugely let down when the side doesn't perform and play up to expectation. I think anybody with a realistic view on this tournament knew that, you know, we weren't one of the favourites, so let's get that into perspective. But nevertheless, we've underperformed, and I feel hugely sorry. And, you know, in the role that I'm in, I'm very responsible for that. And we have to try our hardest to make sure that that won't happen again. Where did it go wrong? I just don't think we ever established a solid base in terms of, you know, people performing. Confidence comes with winning, and we haven't won a consecutive game in one-day cricket for more than a year. We've won one and then not won the next one. And that eats away at players. I don't think it's down to preparation. I think the guys have worked fantastically hard. I've just come back from New Zealand where, you know, the guys have worked really hard and there's some very talented players there. But it sort of highlights in a way that we're a long way behind other countries at the moment in one-day international cricket. We've tried hard, you know, in terms of the way in which we've approached the game, the sort of players we've looked to pick, you know, the emergence of Moeen Ali, for example, at the top of the order. We've scored 300 on a couple of occasions now, which we hadn't done for a long time. The way we started with Ian Bell, you know, when we first went to Australia in the Tri-Series, all of that was very promising, but we've not been able to put it together consistently. And I think it is a fact that, you know, not many of our players play much T20 cricket, full stop, whether it be abroad or at home. And that to me is the biggest lesson, I think, coming out of this tournament, that how much T20 is influencing one-day cricket now. What's really happened in this tournament, which has come home to me, is the crossover really between T20 and 50-over cricket now. It's immense. And some of the scores we've been seeing and the way in which people attack throughout the game, you've got to try and get wickets and you've got to put people under pressure. And we've just not been able to do that. The fact is that you know, we're in a big transitional period. The successful side that we had from 2009 to 2013, you know, has broken up really a year or so ago, and we're still trying to put the pieces back again. I think what's really important is that we understand how disappointed we are. I mean, I'm a huge England fan, and I'm as disappointed as anybody can be out there, let alone what the players are feeling at the moment. But it's maybe the opportunity to look forward and to really work very hard at putting it right. And the first thing we have to do is to emphasise one-day cricket a little bit more than we have in the past. Test cricket in this country is still the senior game. It's still the predominant game. And if you look at track records, past performances, people focus on test match performances, not one-day performances. It's clear around the world that is not necessarily the case. And when it comes to global tournaments, you get very exposed. And we've just been exposed over the last 6 weeks or so. Yes, you don't want to detract what we're doing in Test cricket, but somehow we have to emphasise one-day cricket more. It's very difficult when you look at the schedules. You know, we've got 17 Test matches coming up in 9 months, and we've got 20, 25 one-day internationals. You can never play your strongest side in all of those games. But we have to dig very deeply. We've already started planning for 2019. We had a long list of 70 players we were looking at the other day who are in the system at the moment. I'd be disappointed if some people don't emerge over the next 4 years who we haven't even thought of. But we have to work on developing, you know, a stronger feel for the game, I think. And that has to start, you know, lower down than professional cricketers now. But it's something that we're actively looking at. You know, Peter Moores came in 10 months ago. We're very early in trying to turn English cricket around from, you know, losing 5-0 in the Ashes and the breakup of that side. And we've got to be patient. You know, now's not the time to be making any decisions. Everybody's raw. You saw Owen Morgan's interview on the TV, just how shell-shocked in a way and how gutted people are. So we've got one more game to play. We'd like to finish with a win. We then come back and we set about putting some of these things right.